والله يدعو إلى دار السلام ويهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم.
اللهم أعن على صيامه وقيامه وجنبني من هفواته وآثامه وارزقني ذكرك بدوامه بتوفيقك يا هادي المضلين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Verily we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He deserves to be praised, and we seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil of our souls and the consequences of our sins. Indeed, whomever Allah guides, none can misguide, and whomever He chooses to misguide, then none can guide him back to the straight path. I bear witness and I testify that there is no deity that is worthy of our worship or veneration other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness and I testify that Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final prophet and his most perfect worshipper. As to what follows, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed all of us to witness the greatest month of the year. It is the month that some of the scholars of the past would make dua for half the year to be allowed to see it. And then when that month was finished, they would make dua for the other half that Allah accepts their deeds of Ramadan. Now that Ramadan is over, now that all of the chaos and the hecticness of Ramadan, now that all of the pain of fasting, now that all of the excitement of Eid has subsided, the question is, where do we find ourselves? What is the next step? Where are we going from here? O Muslims, realize that the purpose of Ramadan was to demonstrate to you that you could be a better Muslim, that you are capable of leaving a lot of those sins, if not all of them. You are capable of praying to Allah regularly, of being a righteous and holy servant of Allah. Now that Ramadan is over, are you going to destroy all of the good that you have done? Are you going to reject the very blessings Allah has given you? O Muslims, realize that the Lord of Ramadan is the Lord outside of Ramadan as well. The one whom we worship is Ramadan is the same one whom we worship now. Realize that the one who obligated upon us to pray 5 times a day in Ramadan is the same one who has obligated upon us to pray 5 times a day outside of Ramadan. Allah Azza wa Jal has not changed. Our obedience to Him has not changed. Then why is it that we find ourselves so slack, so easy to fall back into our customs and habits? O Muslims, realize that the purpose of Ramadan is to help us boost our iman. And it is only natural that if we started at a low level, when Ramadan comes, we find ourselves going higher and higher and higher and higher until we reach a very high level. And then when Ramadan is over, it is only natural, brothers and sisters, that that plateau will not remain. We are going to go down. But what we need to do is that when we go down, we make sure that we are at the highest level possible from where we started. We don't go back down to where we began Ramadan with. If we have, then Ramadan has been pointless and useless. Ramadan has been worthless for you. It was of no value and benefit. You might as well have not fasted and prayed. How did you benefit if Ramadan has no value in your life? Rather, what should be the case is that we start at a low level. When Ramadan comes, we go high, high, high. When it finishes, no doubt we will go a little bit down. But the gap should still be there. That when Ramadan finishes, we are much better Muslims than when Ramadan started. Such that when the next Ramadan comes, we go even higher. Then we fall just a little bit. Maybe we go up 10 steps, then we go down 3 at Ramadan finishes. Not that I'm encouraging you to go down, but I'm being realistic. None of us can maintain the same level that we had in Ramadan. So we are going to go down a little bit. But when our iman does go down, we need to make sure that it stays within the realms of our religion. That we practice ourselves, that we condition ourselves to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala properly. And there is one point that I really want to concentrate on, and that is the point of salah, the point of prayer. O Muslims, do you realize how important this pillar of Islam is? Do you understand the relevance of this pillar of Islam to your level of religiosity? Some of the scholars of Islam have said that the prayer is such a fundamental pillar of our religion that whoever leaves the prayer might as well have left Islam. And this is not something that they make out of thin air. The Prophet ﷺ said in an authentic hadith, he said, الْعَهْدُ الَّذِي بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَهُمُ الصَّلَاةِ. the covenant or the treaty that I have, meaning with my followers. The treaty that I have with my followers is the prayer. فَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا فَقَدْ كَفَرْ. Whoever leaves the prayer, it is as if he has committed kufr. Whoever leaves the prayer, it is as if there is no Islam left in him. The prayer is the most fundamental pillar of our religion. The prayer is something that if you want to see what your level of religion is, if you want to see how pious and righteous you are, then look at your prayer. Open up the Quran and see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the very first verse. Alif Lam Mim. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِي هُدَى الْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ. The very first condition Allah puts in the Quran. That this is a book that is a guidance for those who are righteous, those who are believing in Allah. Who are they? They are those who pray and establish the prayer. They are those who establish the prayer. Allah says in the Quran, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. The believers are successful. Who are the believers? الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. The first condition is that we were of those who were practicing our salah with the khushu' of Allah, with the righteousness of Allah, with the humbleness of Allah. And the Quran commands us to pray in over 70 verses. Allah commands us to pray. And you know what is amazing? Never in the Quran does Allah merely say pray. Never does the command given sallu, pray, never. Rather, the command is always given wa aqimu salah, alladhina yuqimuna salah, iqamatu salah. And iqamatu salah means establishing the prayer, i.e. perfecting it. This is the bare minimum of being a Muslim. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran that the people of Jahannam are asked, قَالُوا مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَرْ. How did you end up in this blazing fire? Do you know the first response that will be given? قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ. The first thing that they say is that they say, we were not of those who used to pray. The first excuse that they give, how did they end up in the fire of hell, is that they said, we were not of those who used to pray. And the Prophet ﷺ said, whoever does not pray, he might as well be with Fir'aun and Haman and Qarun. He might as well be with the worst people on earth if he doesn't pray. The prayer is the fundamental pillar of Islam. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls it iman in the Quran. Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ يَعْنِي صَلَاتَكُمْ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not cause your iman to go in vain. And the meaning of iman here is the prayer. Why? Because when the Qibla was changed from Jerusalem to Mecca, a number of companions asked the Prophet ﷺ and they said, O Messenger of Allah, what will be the fate of those who used to pray towards Jerusalem and then died before the Qibla was changed? Allah revealed, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ. Allah will not cause your iman to go unrewarded. So Allah called praying iman. And it is the only action in the entire Quran that Allah calls iman. The prayer itself is called iman. And therefore, the status of prayer is one that by unanimous consensus of the scholars, it is the most important obligation as a Muslim. And remember, when the Prophet ﷺ said, Islam is built upon five pillars, this is not a building. These are merely the pillars. These are the foundations. Many Muslims misunderstand and they think Islam is only five pillars. No, these are the pillars upon which the building stands. And the bare minimum that you need is five. How can a building stand when the second pillar is not there? The first pillar, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. The very second pillar is that of the prayer. How do you expect the building to stand when the very pillar that is there is missing? O Muslims, realize that the salah is a sign of your iman. The very first question that Allah will ask you on the Day of Judgment, the first question Allah will ask you is your prayer. The Prophet ﷺ said, if your prayer is in order, the rest of your affairs will be in order. And if your prayer is messed up, if your prayer is missing, if your prayer is not perfect, then the rest of your affairs will not be perfect. The Prophet ﷺ said, whoever prays continuously and perfectly, he has a promise with Allah that Allah will forgive the rest of his sins. O Muslims, Ramadan is over. We managed to pray to Allah in this month. Now that we have perfected our prayer, let us continue this bare minimum. Let us continue this prayer. The prayers is not an option. pray before people pray over you. You had better pray before people pray over you at the time of your death. Do you want to see your place in Jannah? Look at the status of your prayer, and that will tell you how good of a Muslim you are. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who establish the prayer. Wa akhru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahumma a'inna ala siyami wa qiyami وجنبني من هفواتي وأثامي وارزقني ذكرك بدوامي بتوفيقك يا هادي المضل.